Hello, today we'll be doing a LeetCode problem that is online stock span. This is a pretty good problem. So I'll be showing you two answers or two approaches to this similar problem, in which the first one is going to give a TLE and then the better one. So let's get to the problem. That is, design an algorithm that collects daily price quotes for some stock and returns the span of that stock price for the current day. The span of the stock's price today is defined as the maximum number of consecutive days starting from today and going backward for which the stock price was less than or equals to today's price. So I'll just explain this given example right here. So what does this problem say? I'll just explain it to you. So at first, you have been given the price as 100. So this will be coming, okay? So at first day, we have got 100. So I do not see previously that I have any someone smaller to me. So 100 is less than or equals to 100. So the answer is 1 for it. After that, I've got 80 here. So for 80, I'll check 80 is less than or equals to 80. That is true. And I'll check for previous 7 consecutive days. But I just have 1. So I'll just compare it with 100. And 100 is not smaller than 80, so still the answer remains same. Now 60, likewise, I'll just compare it with 80 and 100, the answer remains as 1. But when I come to the next one, that is 70, when I've been given the price as 70, I see previously I had someone which is smaller than 70 and 70 is less than or equals to 70, so I get the answer as 2 right here. After that, I come to 60, I see that I have got someone which is greater than 60, so I will not take it. And mind you, we have just we just need to take the consecutive days and not the previous smaller ones, okay? So as we can see here, I've got 60 here and I have someone to my left that is smaller than or equals to 60, but I will not take that since it is not consecutive. So if I'm standing here, I'll just see how many consecutive elements are smaller than 60 right here. So that is not the case right here. So I'll just return a 1. After that, 75, I see 60 smaller, 70 smaller, as well as 60 smaller. So I get 4 as my answer. That is right here. And after that, I go to 85 and I'll check what all elements are smaller than 85. The consecutive elements, mind you. So 75, 60, 70, 60, 80, all these elements are smaller than 85, and as well as it is consecutive. So number of elements that here are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and including 85 as well. So it is 6. So this is how the problem goes. And now let's get to the intuition part on how we are going to solve it. So first of all, I'm going to explain the naive approach. Not exactly the naive approach, it is you could say it will work sometimes if the value is smaller, but it's going to give a TLE for now, since the value right here that is it is said that 10 to the power 4 calls will be made. So what do we see here? I will be explaining the naive one first. So this is the I'll just uncomment this out. I've commented it. So this is my naive approach right here. Just comment this out. I've taken two stacks right here. And what is the significance of two stacks? I'll just explain it to you. You could also take a vector right here, but I've taken two stacks. So my intuition right here is that I've got one stack right here. I've got another stack right here. This is stack 1, this is stack 2. So at first, when I get 100, what I'll do is I'll just place it here, 100. And I'll check if there is someone which is less than or equals to the price. So when I go inside, so I see that this is the only element. So fine by me, I do not need to do anything. So the answer is 1 right here. After that, I see that I've got 80 right here. So what will I do? That is, I'll put 10. 80 right here. I'll put in 80 right here. And mind you, whatever the variables that I've used here, I'll be explaining that. So let's just get the first intuition properly, and then I'll explain why I've taken two stacks and all these things. So this is also done. So 100 is not smaller than this, so I won't do anything. Again, I've got a 60 right here. So the previous elements are bigger, so I won't do anything. And if you can see that this is what, this is nothing but a decreasing stack, right? So after that, I get 70. I make a call for 70. 70 has been sent. Okay. Now I see that someone at the top, that is 60, is smaller than 70 right here, isn't it? So what will I do is I will increment my counter by one. I will increment my counter by one. I'll say I have someone which is smaller than this. So what will I do? I'll just put it into this stack right here, this stack, and this is right here, and I'll just remove this from here. Now I'll compare 70 with 80. Is it true? Is 80 less than 70? I'll say no, this is not less than 70. So what do I have, what does my counter stand at right now? For this 70, I know this will be less than or equals to 70 surely. And for other element, that is 60, the counter shall increase by one, right? It shall increase by one. So after I'm done comparing with everything, what do I have? I have this right here. So what will I do? I'll just simply transfer every element right here till here. That is 80 and 100 as well. Nothing too complicated. It's just a simple algorithm. I'm just checking if this condition is true. If yes, then I'm just pushing it here and I'm just pushing it right back. So I've done that, and this is how the algorithm works. And if you could not understand it, I'll just tell you that if you dry run it, you'll understand this properly. So I am moving to the better approach. I'll just comment this out. I'm not running this because this will give me TLE. That is why I'm not running it. So I'll just explain the optimal approach right away. The optimal approach is using stacks, only one stack, and taking pairs. And why did I take this? I'll just go through this. Just hear me out. This is a very interesting one. So what I'm doing right here is I'm taking a stack and making a pair and taking span is equals to one. And what this is doing is, first of all, I'll have my stack right here. This is my stack. I put in 100 and one. So my stack is empty right now at first. So what will I do? I'll just push in the stack. Okay. After that, what am I going to do? I'm going to just push in 80 and 1. 80 and 1. Why 1? See, because I've told that if my price is greater than or equals to st.top. So my top was what? 100 previously, and I'm comparing it with 80. So that is my answer. Comparison being done here. So what does it say? It says that is 80 greater than or equals to 100. That is false, right? So I'll just push in what? The price and the span, that is equals to one. So similarly, I'll do this. And then comes what? Then comes my main point. That is 70. When I make a call for 70, I'm taking the inputs from here. Okay. For reference. When I see that, I'll see that 70 is greater than or equals to my top elements first. That is equals to 60, isn't it? It is indeed greater. 70 is indeed greater. So what will I do? I'll just say you pop this guy out and increase span. Span was what previously? 1. 60 had a span of 1, right? So I'll just say increase the span's value by 1, that is 2. Increase the value of span by 1. And after that, what am I gonna do? I'm just gonna push in 70 and 2. Why 2? Because my span has been incremented by 1 right here, in this statement right here. That is what I did. After that, when I go to the next iteration, I'll just compare 70 with 80. That will never happen. That is why I just directly pushed it into the stack. After that, I go to 70 and I go to 60, I see 60 is not greater than 70. Move on, 75. I go to 75. So mind you, I'm just writing it here. My stack continues, okay? Right from here. My stack is continuing. And what was the span's value? The span's value was nothing but 2 right here. Right there, right? It was 2. Previously, mind you, I had the value previously as 2 for 70. After that, what have I done? I've gone to 60 and 2, which I removed already. After that, I go to 75 and I compare. And I compare. I just simply compare. Is 75 greater than or equals to 60? Is it? It is indeed. So I'll just increment my span by 1 again. Again, I'll check for this right here, 70. Is my span greater than 1? It is indeed. So I'll increment by 1. So at last, I get a 4, total of 4. And this is how the algorithm works. So I hope you have understood. If you have not understood, just dry run this solution once. You'll completely get it. It's not a big deal. You'll get it. I'll just run this code and show you it is getting accepted. So the time complexity right here is, so we are just running this loop, right, for once. And what are we doing? The next operation, mind you, is just taking me O of 1 every time. Every time is just taking me O of 1. And the main thing right here to see is, at the worst case, it will be indeed O of 1. But I can say amortized time complexity will be O of 1. Now, you would argue, why would it be O of 1? I'm saying amortized time complexity. Why? See, because what are we doing? At 70, we do some operations, right? We do some operations. At 75, we do some operations. At 85, we do some operations. But the main operations that we are doing every time, that is push, that is taking me O of 1. Retrieving the span, whatever it is also an O of 1 operation. So we can say at max, whatever we are doing, the operation maximum times, we are doing it in one O of 1 times. So we can say the amortized time complexity is O of 1. And in the worst case, obviously it will be O of n, surely. And space will also be O of n, surely. Okay, so this is a space and time complexity. I've already submitted this code. If you want it, you can just copy it from here. And thank you.